Thomas Maiden, Head of Analytics and Credit at Principal. In our series of COVID-19 and credit, we'll be looking at how the COVID-19 crisis is affecting credit models. Thank you for joining us. In this installment, we'll be looking specifically at the credit bureau score and credit bureau models and how these are affected by the crisis. So how is the crisis affecting a consumer's credit bureau score? Well, I think the first thing to note is that the credit bureau score is used across the customer lifecycle, from acquisitions, looking for new customers, originations, onboarding customers, account management, managing customers, collections, and not to forget IFRS 9 models as well. So it's worth looking at all those different areas to understand how the models may be affected. The next thing to look at is also the different periods in time. We're calling them the shock period, the initial period, then the immediate aftermath, and then the long-term aftermath. And we expect different activities to happen across these different periods of time. So the loss of jobs, reduced wages, shrinking of the economy, we'll see the score predicting differently. Score to odds relationship today will be different in the long run. In the short term, we expect payment holidays to come into effect. As we know, the banks and retailers have announced that there will be payment holidays for customers in the short term, certain customers certainly. So the score to odds relationship today will be different. Will be different in the long run, despite the fact that the scores may look quite flat. The next thing to note is that variables often found in the scorecard, such as time since last payment, may score slightly lower in the short term, and then but other variables such as cycle delinquency variables will look a lot stabler in the short term. So overall score should reduce slightly, not that much, but over-predict on a score to odds basis. The summary is now is the time it's time to be extra cautious in your strategies. In the immediate aftermath, this is the period that we're particularly worried about. We will likely see a drop, potentially significantly, of the score and a general worsening of the credit bureau profile of customers. Keep an eye out for the reports on the size of customers with non-performing loans in South Africa. We will no doubt see a significant increase there. So the shape of your book in terms of risk profile may change quite significantly at this point. The long-term aftermath, well, we're talking the period of maybe 6-12 months, maybe 24 months afterwards. All scenarios at this stage paint a negative view of the economy. We believe the drop will be quite severe over the immediate aftermath and that the recovery will be long and hard. Credit bureau scores use a customer's historic behavior, particularly over the last 2 years, so the shockwave will be felt for a long time after 2020 into 2021 and 2022 particularly. So data will also be unreliable over this period for calibration and modeling. Analysts will need to get a lot more creative when it comes to credit assessment and setting strategies based on historic data from the coronavirus period. It's also worth noting that certain sectors of society will be harder hit than others. In the SME space, you should have very good segmentation based on industry. On the consumer side, you'll also have people employed in certain industries. And if you have this data, you'll be able to set strategies based on those customer segments. So what should lenders look to do over the short, medium and long term with respect to the use of credit bureau scores? I think one thing that we're saying to everyone right now is to monitor. Reduce the time period in which you monitor. So you may be looking at performance over 3 to 6 to 9 to 12 months. You might need to reduce this to 1 to 2 to 3 months. You need every indication of changes in terms of the shape of your portfolio so you can act as quickly as you can. Then the other thing to do is, and you can do this fairly immediately, is to reduce your aggressive strategies. So you may have some borderline cases where you've granted credit in the past or extended additional credit in the past. You may now need to turn off those taps and actually not extend credit to those customers. Then the next thing is to speak to your credit bureaus about how they believe the score will change over time. They're closer to their scores and they will be closer to their variables and what they might be doing with them. And therefore it might be worth chatting to them to keep an eye out exactly what is going on in that space and then adapt your strategies accordingly. Not only monitor your portfolio, but also monitor the bureau score and also bureau key variables, particularly policy rules, or variables that are used in policy rules, and keep an eye out on these from day, from week to week to week. And the next thing is address credit bureau changes across the customer lifecycle. We mentioned it before, but you'll be using your credit bureau score potentially for acquisitions, for originations, for account management, collections, and IFRS 9 models. So there will be an effect in all of these different areas, not just in the origination space where most people may focus initially. Then look at your data science capability and capacity. So do you have the right size and skilled teams to help navigate through these tough times? If you don't, you reach out for help because you need to act now. So thank you. I'm Thomas Maiden, and thank you for joining us. Feel free to comment below, send us an email, and please subscribe to get more information and more updates around new postings. And we look forward to speaking to you again. Thank you.